Ludlow Porch.
Well, good morning, fun seekers.
How y'all?
It is Friday. We are glad you are with us. It's that special day we save for you because we realize that during the week it's hard to get in here sometimes for one reason or other, so we make Friday your catch-up day. And we've got folks been on hold a long time. We're going to get back with them and go now to Irvington, Kentucky, home of the legendary Dick Freimeyer, who is anchored in, standing by. Good morning, Mr. Freimeyer.
Good morning, Cousin Ludlow.
How you doing?
Pretty good for an old plug this morning.
Well, I'm glad.
Yes, sir. Everything's going, looks like going pretty good so far today.
Well, good, good.
Yeah, and too many things happen here in Irvington. Temperature right now is approaching the 50-degree mark. We had another one of those hot snows up here.
Did you?
Yeah, I finally missed one. I told them, I said, that's one of those hot snows.
Hot snow.
Well, I guess, you Atlanta fans, looks like Falcons going to win another. Ted pecked out yesterday Atlanta Falcons would win by 7 points. So it looks like another exciting game.
All right.
For
them. I love it.
And they on the road, too. The experts tell me it's hard to win on the road sometimes.
Good news from our rooster buddy.
Yeah. Well, tell you what, this banana peel on the forehead and the back of the neck,
uh-huh.
I've had my third case of people wanting to sue me over that.
Uh-huh.
Why in the world are daggone people? I've got them all straightened out, but apparently they're going by the November the 30th thing to Ann Landers when they were writing about the success of it. And this daggone commercial-grade duct tape, folks, I have never said use that. We got three cases now where it pulled the skin off the people's forehead, and I think they're about ready to scalp me over it. And I told them, I said, I did not say that. I said, go back to the November 30th article, and you see, that's the people, the readers that are writing that, not me.
Yeah, you're innocent.
I want to make that perfectly plain now.
Well,
I had nothing to do with saying anything about duct tape.
Okay.
I thought this was going, I heard Denny laugh. Denny, it's not funny now. Person threatened to sue you. You know, you can already see the dollar bills going out, you know.
Uh-huh.
And sometimes that makes me nervous.
Yeah.
Yeah, I heard that. You got Ted on it now. Golly. And, folks, let me tell you one other thing. If you do want the books in time for Christmas, if you'll give me a call at my office or home, we will get the books out of here today or tomorrow, and you will have them before Christmas. Ludlow, if you'll permit, I'll give my phone numbers out, please.
Okay, is that
my office number is 502-547-3951. Home number is 502-547-2553, and you can have both the books for $30. And like I've always said, if you don't like them, you send them back, and you'll get your $30 back. Reason I say this, I'm the boss.
Okay.
You can't get any better than that, can you?
You just cannot get any better. Just not getting any better than that.
And folks, everybody have a real nice Christmas and holiday. I love all of you, and I appreciate you. All the many Christmas cards, I counted through finally yesterday afternoon. We had 1,727 when I quit counting. I appreciate that. From all over the country, I've gotten Christmas cards. I thought they were out of fashion, tell you the truth.
Let me ask you a question.
Yes, sir.
On that banana thing?
Yes, sir.
On the forehead? Okay to use duct tape?
No.
Okay. No duct tape.
No, please, no duct tape. Now, what I use when the people, I had a couple of people down here yesterday afternoon, I use an ace bandage because it's much easier because my right arm, I'm just mostly a one-arm person.
But no.
I can't use my right arm very good. That's the reason I use an ace bandage. But you can just use a plain old cloth, folks, and wrap that around your head.
You
the peel has to be, the mushy side has to be next to the skin.
How about a rope?
Oh, no, it's still correct. Somebody'd be hanging herself, and they'd be blaming me for that, too.
I'll see you later, Frank.
Still use that commercial-grade duct tape.
All right, buddy,
please.
You take care of yourself.
Don't get the crowd out.
I'll talk to you.
Bye-bye.
You know what I just realized, Denny? In spite of all he's told me over the years, I've never crowed. More conversation right after this. I was looking at a TV commercial from a car dealer the other day, and they were tickled nearly about to death because they had 10 Jeep Wranglers in stock. They had 10 Wranglers in stock, and they bought a TV commercial to shout the news. Listen, gang, right this minute, Jasper Jeep has about 70 Wranglers sitting on their lot. Hardtop, soft top, dual top. Pick a color, pick the equipment, and drive it home. They also have the beautiful new Dodge Durango and those great Dodge Ram pickups, all at those wonderful no-hassle, no-haggle Jasper Jeep, Dodge, Chrysler, Plymouth prices. Great time for you to see the beautiful Georgia Mountains and meet the nicest folks I know at Jasper Jeep, Dodge, Chrysler, Plymouth. Now then, open Monday through Saturday, 8 a.m. to 7 p.m., but never, ever on Sunday. Gang, no matter where you live, your car dealership is situated in beautiful Jasper, Georgia.
Panasonic Wet or Dry Electric Razors presents Famous Choices That Never Were. Admiral Byrd, discoverer of the North Pole.
I wish I would have discovered Bermuda.
Ugg, discoverer of fire.
Ugg, regret not getting patent.
Don't get burned. Exercise your right to choose with the Panasonic Wet or Dry Electric Razor. Anytime, anywhere, wet or dry, Panasonic says, shave your way.
Fire give Ugg close shave too, but talk about razor burn.
Don't be a monkey's uncle. Choose Panasonic.
Local talk the way it's supposed to be. It's John Breffel.
My guest in the studio this morning, Mayor and Chair of Athens-Clarke County, Gwenolunni. John Barrow, Commissioner, District 4, is on the John Breffel Show.
No heavy topics here, gang, just fun conversation. I'm Ludlow Porch. Join me weekdays 10 to noon on News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
I'll be coming home. Coming home for Christmas. Honey, you can bet it's true. I'll be coming home for Christmas. Baby, wanna be by you. Baby, wanna be by you.
Yeah. Baby, Albany, Georgia. Big Mac on the radio.
I'll be coming home.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
How you doing?
Suppose you don't have any duct tape. You reckon you could use rub of cement?
Now, let's leave Primeyer alone. He gets all out of shape.
Doesn't he get bent out of shape? It's the first chance I've had to call you since I saw you Saturday down here. And just want to say how nice it was to have you in the city.
Well, it was fun. We had a good time.
Real good. Sold a lot of books.
Sold them all.
I didn't get to buy any books, but we wound up spending about $80 on videotapes.
Well, you were just a little late, as I recall.
Yeah, we had been out of town most of the day down in Thomasville,
mm-hmm,
shopping, and came back and dropped by. So I just wanted to, didn't have anything special, I just wanted to call and wish all you guys very Merry Christmas and the happiest of New Year.
Well, I enjoyed being with you, and I was sorry I was a little tied up and couldn't spend as much time talking as I wanted to. But
no problem.
We'll make up for it next time.
Well, we saw each other in November, and now in December, you were going to have to cut back somehow.
Maybe we'll taper off, man.
Yeah.
Big boy, you have a great, great Christmas if I don't talk to you again.
Thank you so much. Right. Best to you and all your family.
All right, buddy. Thank you.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Telstar International Communications, gang. Long distance for 10 cents a minute. Home or business. No tricks ever. Bulldog Betty is on board. Good morning, my love.
Good morning, good morning. This is the Lustrous Potentate.
It is.
Well, it's just about that time. We would assume that all the halls are decked and all the other, you know, anything else that you want to deck.
That's right. But now's the time of the year to do a little decking.
Now's the time to have at it.
Yes.
And, of course, with the holidays, I promised you that we would have to get into this. There comes the time when you've got to have a party. Sooner or later, the social obligations pile up.
Yep.
And if you have time, I thought we would touch on a few notes on the party, both being the host and a guest.
All right.
Cheapskate's handbook.
Oh, I love it.
Okay?
Yeah.
Of course, we all know the object of a party is a good time. But how can you expect to enjoy yourself when you're shelling out, probably as much as $50 to amuse a bunch of people that you probably don't even like to start with.
Mm-hmm.
So let's... The Cheapskate's handbook suggests the following. Make it a BYOB party, of course.
Yeah.
And refill a bottle with an expensive label on it with the cheap stuff. Don't worry, nobody's going to know the difference. And water down everything else. They may know the difference, but who cares? Okay?
Yeah.
Make sure you drink all the booze your guests bring before you serve any of your own. If anyone shows up with a case of beer, put that in the garage for later.
And that's the Cheapskate handbook, right?
Of course.
Uh-huh.
If I believe you have to serve food, I mean, if it's one of these parties that you just can't get around serving food, look through the refrigerator for something that's about to go bad. Oh. Mix it with sour cream and call it clam dip.
If it's turning green, it's clam dip.
When you make out your guest list, make sure you have a couple of doctors, a couple of lawyers, investment counselors, and some of these other professionals.
Mm-hmm.
Then spend the evening badgering them and getting free advice.
Yeah, there you go.
If you have a teenage son, preferably a son, I guess, dress him as a valet in charge for parking.
Oh, nice.
I mean, if you just stop and think about it, this guy, he probably is a billionaire by this time.
He's turning a dollar on everything.
Yes, sir. So that takes care of the host responsibility. Now, if you're invited to a party, don't eat for 3 days. Then stuff yourself so you won't have to eat for 3 days afterward. And always get there early. With luck, you can polish off most of the hors d'oeuvres before anybody else even gets there. Always bring the cheapest bottle of wine you can find.
The kind you can put in your cigarette lighter if you need to.
Or take paint off your windshield or something.
Yeah.
And last but not least, never leave with less booze than you brought.
You remember our Cajun friend Boo Boo?
Never forget Boo Boo.
When Boo Boo was living in Atlanta, Boo Boo was a man of great appetites.
I had sort of gathered that.
Yeah, Boo Boo weighs upward of 400 pounds.
Big old boy.
Yeah, and one of the finest Cajun cooks and one of the great party throwers of all times. He was invited to a Christmas party by a young lady who worked for him. And he was really excited, and he said, bring your own bottle. So he did, a couple of them, I presume. And the only thing they had there to eat was one package of potato chips.
Oh, no.
Boo-Boo raved about that for 6 months. 6 months. I thought...
I thought your boy was going to have a stroke.
Well, I thought that the woman who worked for him was going to get fired.
It's a wonder the girl had not lost her job on the spot.
No telling.
That's funny. One bag of potato chips.
Yeah, for the probably 15 people.
You take care of yourself, and you and Miss Nancy have the greatest holiday ever. And just make sure that you keep your beeper with you, so if Denny gets in trouble, as he is wont to do, as we know, he can find you.
I don't own a beeper.
Are they the devil's invention or what?
Because when I'm not here, I don't want to be found.
When you're not there, you're not there, period. When you're not there, you're nowhere.
Slap gone.
Slap gone. Have a happy, happy one. We will talk to you soon.
Okay, my friend. Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, my dear.
1-800-572-8255. More right after this. Nearly about to death.
Hey, guys, what's the problem?
The weather.
What do you mean? It's warm and beautiful outside.
Exactly. No snow, no Santa. Which means I've been good all year for nothing. This is gonna be a miserable Christmas.
Well, maybe not, fellas.
Well, I've been sort of worried about Santa Claus this year.
You're worried? My life's riding on this delivery.
'Cause we live away down south, and it didn't snow down here. But I'm telling you not to worry, 'cause I just got the word. Everybody listen closely, and I'll tell you what I heard.
What?
Santa's coming in a pickup instead of his trusty sleigh.
Somehow, pickup just takes the romance out of that, doesn't it? Albany, Georgia, and Jerry on the radio. Hi, Jerry.
Good morning, Ludlow. Good How are you?
I'm fine, sir. How you doing?
Fine, and a Merry Christmas to you and all of yours.
Thank you.
Do a little history police work here.
All right.
Vince was close, but he doesn't get the cigar. Dr. Clement Clark Moore was an Episcopal priest. And he was a teacher at the General Theological Seminary in New York City. And if you're in New York and you're between 9th and 10th Avenues on 23rd Street, that's where Dr. Moore's house was. He lived in his wife's farmhouse. And he wrote this wonderful Christmas story, riding home in his horse and buggy to give to his children.
Mm-hmm.
And the General Seminary is built in his apple orchard, which is still there. And at that time, it was on the banks of the Hudson River.
Fascinating.
But yeah, he was an Episcopal priest, and he taught, they called them modern languages at that time, Hebrew and Greek.
All right.
Just a little, don't want the revisionist history to get too far.
Okay, buddy.
Happy holidays.
I'm glad you called. Same to you. Thanks a million.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Let's go to Shannon, Georgia, and talk to Perlene. Hello there. How you doing?
Pretty good. How about you?
I'm doing good.
Well, good. I was afraid I was going to follow Bulldog Betty, and I thought, oh, my, my, my. But I didn't have to. I enjoy her, and I enjoy your program.
Thank you.
No, I was going to tell you, my mother had six girls, no boys, and they were all gone except three of us. Well, last Christmas, my oldest sister, she wanted us to come up and make Christmas dinner for her because she'd had a stroke.
Yeah.
Well, we did. And then July the 3rd, she passed away, but it's not sad. This year, I got my Christmas decorations out and put them up because I didn't do it last year. Nobody was going to see them.
Mm-hmm.
But it is, it's a pleasure to be able to talk to you and help people to understand life does go on.
Yep. Yep, and sometimes it leaves a hole in your heart.
Sure it does.
But
yeah.
But it does go on.
Yeah, we were real close. I mean, closer than the rest of them because a lot of times I would have my finger in the dial, and the phone would ring.
Yeah.
That's just, you know, our mind worked together.
Yeah.
And but it's a joy to talk to you, and I wish you a Merry Christmas.
Well, I hope this is the best one of your life, and I thank you for calling.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Hey, jumpstart your Christmas by seeing the Appalachian Lights at Burt's Farm in Dawson County, Georgia. You call 1-800-600-BERT. For details, 1-800-572-8255, Gadsden and Ace. Good morning, Ace.
Good morning, Ludlow.
How you, friend?
Fine. Merry Christmas to you and Danny and your family and all.
Thank you, buddy.
Enjoy your program.
Thank you.
I got something unusual this morning.
All right.
You know, I'm a great dog lover with tips and all, but right now in Oregon, they've got a dog over there that they're fixing to execute. It happened that the dog's named Natus. He's an adorable black and brown and white collie, Malinois mix. I'd like for your dog lovers to try to help him out by writing a letter to the governor. They've got an old archaic law there about livestock and dogs, and this dog slipped out of his leash one day and just playfully romped with the neighbor's girl's horse running around, didn't bite it, didn't hurt it at all whatsoever. But because you've chased it, the horse wasn't harmed or in the slightest. But their law is that they must be killed. And they've appealed and spent money and everything. And it's just, if the people would write a letter to the governor, that's Governor John Kitzhaber, Kitzhaber.
Mm-hmm.
And it's at 254 State Capitol Building, Salem, Oregon. And that's 97310.
All right, and just ask for clemency for this.
We won't ask him for a pardon for Natus. And if we just flood the governor with this, it may help because they're really going by that old archaic law.
Yeah. Listen, I got to run, buddy.
I know you have, and I appreciate it, but I want to get this out to the dog lovers.
Thanks for the call.
Thank you.
We'll be right back. Stay with us. Thank you. 1-800-572-8255, Sharpsburg, Georgia, and Walt on the radio.
Good morning, buddy.
Hello, old friend. How you doing?
Just fine. I hope you, reminded Danny a while ago, when we was up home in Missouri, we had 3 turkey dinners in 4 days. He said, "What is your stuff?" We was stuffed. Worse than the turkey.
Yeah.
Yes, anyway. Listen, for the veterans out there, in 1960, I was in Korea, being a young whippersnapper, you might say, never been away from home, and we had got a big train in, you know, and unloaded all in the ordnance area, and then the snow came for Christmas, and we had a snow in 1960. I think we had almost 2 feet. And that was a white Christmas.
Yeah.
That was some memory, though.
Yeah,
having never been away from home.
And never having seen a white Christmas, I don't guess. Or had you?
Oh, yeah. Back home in Missouri, yeah. We had a few. Okay. Not many, though.
Yeah, I got
but, you. Anyway. And, you know, I worked in a hardware store, and that duct tape reminded me a while ago. I enjoy having fun with folks. And I asked a customer the other day if he wanted a non-quacking type of duct tape or not. Caught him off guard. But every now and then somebody says, they really laugh. And that's what makes it fun.
Yeah, you can't get through a day without some good laughter.
Oh, laughter is the most wonderful medicine there ever was invented.
I guarantee you.
Well, I guess it's not invented, though, is it? It's natural. But anyway.
All right, big boy.
Wish you well.
All right, take care. Thanks for the call.
Yeah.
1-800-572-8255 as we go to Marietta, Georgia, and talk to George. Hello, George.
Good morning, Gundo.
Good morning.
And America. How you doing today?
Doing good,
buddy. Beautiful day. It's going to be like summer.
It's 61 degrees. Yes. I can take a lot of that.
That's great. I have a trivia question for you.
All right.
What month do you think Jesus Christ was born?
Well, you know, the only thing I'm sure about there is the experts, biblical scholars, say it was not December. I've heard July, is that right?
No, it was, according to Bible scientists, it was the last week in September or the first week in October.
Okay, and they determined that by the position of the stars.
That's right.
Yeah.
And the Christmas, as we look at it here in December, it's not a holy day. I mean,
it is to me, George.
No, it's really not. If you read the Bible,
George, it is to me.
If you study the Bible,
George, it is to me.
It's not a holy day. Anyway, here's another question, or another thing. You know, it's a sin to drink alcohol. In the Bible, it's got two places in there. It says that strong kings, which is you and me, we don't drink alcoholic beverages.
Where does it say that, John?
In the Bible. And there's another...
I mean, can you pin it down any more than that?
No, I don't do that. See, that's one thing I don't want to do on your show, is pin it down.
Okay.
As you would say. People get mad at me. They send hate mail, probably.
How about take a little wine for the stomach's sake?
No, only 3 ounces, which would represent the blood of Jesus. 3 ounces a night of wine is all I drink. And that's to represent the blood of Jesus, the crimson blood of Jesus.
Okay.
He died on the cross. That's it for me. I mean, it's up to you, but, you know, no man, no person is going to enter the door when you're full of sins, you know. So it's up to you. If you want to go get drunk on Christmas, that's an abomination unto Jesus Christ. So why do it? Why make more sins in your life?
Well,
why ruin more people's lives, too?
I don't think you ought to get drunk any time. Let me get back to this birthday again. I really don't think it's important that we celebrate it on the day.
No, it doesn't matter.
Okay.
It's good to celebrate it on the 25th.
Okay.
You know, there's nothing wrong with that. It was set aside for that.
Okay.
But the biblical view of scientists say it was on the last week or first.
Yeah, I knew they had lined up the stars and that sort of thing. I knew they probably knew.
I hope nobody, when they have these Christmas parties, you know, they get drinking and then they get driving. And they kill so many innocent people. You know,
yeah, that's
right there.
Yep.
Yep, and we have, with the laws in the country what they are now, we have reached a point where you just can't do that. You just can't do that. They don't fool around with these folks anymore like they used to. People are going to jail for long terms, as they should. I don't have any problem with that.
Satan says, have another one. Have another one. I know I was full of Satan at one time, and I drank a little bit. And that's what he would do. He would push more drinks. Maybe somebody would buy a drink. Maybe you'd get 3-for-1 drinks. And they'd get drunker and drunker. It was a terrible, miserable, rotten life.
Bad way to live. Bad way to live. Gotta go, George.
Have a nice weekend, and I'll call you again.
All right, you take care of yourself. 1-800-572-8255, Griffin, Georgia, and the lovely El Prida. Hello, young lady.
Hello, Ledlow. Merry Christmas.
And Merry Christmas to you.
Gus gave me a recipe for tea cakes a year or so ago, and they are real good. But when I moved, it got packed away somewhere, and I haven't been able to find it. And if Gus is listening, I wish he'd give me his wife's recipe for the tea cakes. They're real good.
Okay, and they're in a box somewhere and you can't find them.
Yes.
All right.
And I got a little funny episode to tell you. This man had decided that his wife was developing a hearing problem. And he decided one day that she was sitting at the table, and he thought, well, I'll just go ahead and find out. So he stood about 10 feet behind her, and he said, can you hear me? And she didn't say nothing. So he walked up about 5 feet behind her and said, can you hear me? And still nothing. So he got right out, and he said, can you hear me? She said, for the third time, yes.
Good story. Good story. I'm glad you called, my love.
Y'all have a nice holiday.
We're going to do it. We'll talk to you before then, I hope.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
All right. 1-800-572-8255. I want to tell you again about our trip to England and Scotland. This is going to be something. Somebody asked me the other day, can we take our golf clubs? And I said, of course. You're going to find that there've been some arrangements made, and will be arrangements made for you to have a golf outing. You ask about that when you call and ask them about the golf clubs, because if you're a golfer, to go to Scotland and not play on one of these world-famous courses might be a sin. Let me give you the number where you can get all the details. We're leaving April 23rd, be back May 2nd. Call 1-800-906-4232. 1-800-906-4232. Golfer or not, you're going to love this trip. First class all the way. 1-800-906-4232. You call today.
There will come a time when she gets straight A's, graduates from an Ivy League school, and becomes your daughter, the MD. But first, she has to get through kindergarten.
When children feel confident about learning, anything's possible. With Edmark's Millie and Bailey Kindergarten software, kids can get a head start with reading, math, and science. Stop by your local software store or call 888-750-LEARN. Edmark, ignite the curious mind.
Sports Talk 960.
Boom, digga, 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 boom, digga, boom.
Joining us from Baseball Weekly is the editor, Paul White. Paul, how are you this afternoon?
Doing great, guys.
Why do you think the Braves would have not wanted to re-sign Blauzer? He had a great season, and we were talking earlier, it doesn't seem like money would be a factor, considering, you know, Ted Turner's their owner, and the guy can give $1 billion to the UN. I mean, obviously, you could pay a guy like Blauzer.
Sports Talk 960 on News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
Hey, you listen to the Ludlow Port Show weekdays, 10 to noon on News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
I'm dreaming tonight of a place I love even more than I usually do. And although I know it's a long road back, I promise. I'll be home for Christmas.
Albany, Georgia, and Kendall. Good morning, Kendall.
Morning, Letty. How you doing?
I'm good, bud. You okay?
Doing all right.
Good.
Looking forward to Christmas, I guess.
Yeah, we all are.
Yeah. You ever did any Christmas caroling? You ever went out Christmas caroling with a church group or anything?
No, I haven't, but I've had a chance to enjoy a lot of carolers.
Yeah, I'm the youth pastor of a church down in Putney, a little town right outside of Albany, and we're getting ready, I guess, around the first of the week, Monday night. I think we're going to go through the neighborhood, do a little Christmas caroling.
Oh, that's great.
We enjoy that every year.
Sure, that's wonderful.
I called for the first time yesterday. I've been listening to you for a couple of years now, and called for the first time yesterday and enjoyed it so much I thought I'd call back.
Atta boy.
Couldn't hardly stay away from it.
I love it.
Hey, I got a clean little Christmas joke I want to tell you.
Okay.
Won't take but a minute. It seems that this group of chess enthusiasts, a chess club,
yes,
were standing in the foyer of this fancy hotel in some big town, and this group of chess enthusiasts were out in the foyer boasting and arguing about who was the best chess player among them. And the manager heard the ruckus, and he come out into the foyer there with them, and he said, stop it, you gotta cut this out. And they said, why? And he said, because I can't stand chestnuts boasting in an open foyer.
I love it. Kendall, I'm glad you called again, buddy. Stay in touch now.
Okay, buddy.
All right, talk to you soon.
Take care.
Bye-bye. Oh, that is funny. Billerica, Georgia, and Frank on the radio. Hello, Frank.
Good morning, Lloyd.
How are you, pal?
All right, sir. I'm looking for some trivia information.
All right.
Atlanta's Channel 5, early 60s, locally produced Saturday or Friday night horror show. The host character's name was something like Bistoink Dooley. Not you got any idea who played him?
Not something like Bistoink Dooley. It was Bistoink Dooley. And the gentleman's name was... it just flitted out, and I knew him well. He owned and operated several theaters. Last name was Ellis, and I cannot think of that nice man's...
Elmo?
No, Elmo was WSB. I think George. I think it was George. Somebody will call and correct that, I'm sure.
George Ellis.
Yeah.
Do you have any idea what he did before or after?
He was in the motion picture business. He owned and operated several theaters around town.
Uh-huh.
And he was an actor, too, and a pretty active actor in several movies that were made here and some local stage production. Very talented man. One of the sweetest human beings that ever lived. Had that great big say. Matter of fact, he played Santa Claus to me on the radio several years in a row.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, well, we talked to the kids in the early days. And, yeah, great guy. Great guy.
All right. Well, thank you very much. You just filled in a big hole in my trivia.
Okay, buddy. You take care of yourself. Talk to you soon.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Knoxville, Tennessee. And Linda. Hello, Linda.
Hello.
How are you?
Oh, I'm fine. How are you?
Great.
I was calling to let you know the progress of our daughter, Nicolette.
Yes.
She's really appreciated all the cards and nice letters, and she's gotten a few necklaces, and some people have sent a few dollars, and it's just the cards and all the thoughtfulness and everything has just made her feel a whole lot better.
Well, that's wonderful.
She's doing better. She's a lot better than she was last week, but she's still, she can't stay up a real long time.
Still weak.
She's still very weak.
Mm-hmm.
She had to get a lot of blood, so she's still, they're trying to get it all built up. But she talks a lot better now. She's a lot stronger than she was, and we're hoping another week that she can at least be out in the living room a little bit more. She can come out neat. Her meals, she comes to the table, but right. She stays most of the time in her room right now.
Well, we are delighted that she's improving.
I'm her mom.
Yeah.
I didn't say that.
No, I kind of got that impression.
Right. But she's, and we just all appreciate everybody's thoughtfulness. She looks forward every day to the afternoon, and when the mailman comes, and she has gotten just so many nice cards.
Well, that's wonderful. You give her our love, and I hope her situation continues to improve, and you tell her we said Merry Christmas, and a lot of folks are praying for her. 1-800-572-8255. A Frosty Mountain, pure spring water, gang. Water from the spring, not the tap. It's available at fine stores everywhere. 1-800-572-8255. Formerly the world's foremost civil servant and the pride of the U.S. Postal Service, my buddy Storman Norman, back on the air. Hello, Norman.
Ludlow.
How you doing?
All right. How you doing today?
Merry Christmas.
Same to you. Happy New Year.
Makes you miss being a postman, doesn't it?
Oh, Lord, yeah. I miss it. And Denny, he's up to his old tricks. He answered the phone, bah, humbug. he said he was just gotten in the Christmas spirit. So
he has.
That's good.
Yeah.
You ever go to Mississippi and gamble, or you ever been to Las Vegas?
Yeah.
Last night on 48 Hours, did you see that?
No.
Larry Flint, he went to a hotel. He was using $25,000 chips.
Great Scott.
One chip, $25,000. He lost $1 million at one place, and he went over to another one, and he won $1 million, and then he left.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
That's incredible.
It was. You know, one hand lose or win $50,000.
Yeah, that's incredible. Hard for the average person to...
Yeah, comprehend that.
Yeah,
I bet my $2 and $5 chips, and I'm really sweating on those.
Yeah, standing with tears in your eyes.
Yeah. Did you hear about the woman that greased up her kitchen floor?
Yeah.
Trying to kill her one-legged boyfriend?
Uh-huh.
And she slipped and fell.
Yeah, and then they prosecuted her.
Yeah, for murder.
Yeah.
Attempted murder.
Yeah.
And her husband said, or her boyfriend said, she was just waxing the floor.
Mm-hmm. With the downstairs door open. She was hoping to send him down a long flight of stairs.
Yeah, she's just tired of him.
As I recall.
She wanted a new boyfriend the hard way.
Yeah. Well, that is the hard way, too. And think about getting all it. Well, it was transmission fluid or something. Think about getting that off the floor.
Oh, man, you got time for some stamp information?
Yeah, I got a minute.
Okay. The Postal Service, the operations, our volume is up 3.7%. It just keeps going up. You know, everybody says with the computers and email.
Yeah.
Bulk mail was up 7.2%.
Yeah, I got 4.6% of that bulk mail.
Hey, one other thing. The Postal Service is fixing to issue the largest stamp ever.
How big is it going to be?
3 inches by 1.5 inches. It's the Mars Pathfinder stamp. They had to make it big to get that sucker on there.
Yeah.
with the moon landing and
yeah,
the...
Yeah, yeah.
Remember, be good to your mailman. Give him a cup of coffee.
Oh, okay. Or... I thought there was some slogan going to follow that. You take care of your mailman, and he'll take care of you.
That's right.
Yeah,
he'll remember it the rest of the year. And he won't forget you.
Come on by here and see us, big boy.
I will, and y'all have a Merry Christmas.
All right,
now, pal.
Thank you.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Storman Norman, one of the greats. More conversation right after this. Now is the time, gang, for you to jumpstart your Christmas spirits by visiting the Appalachian Lights at Burt's Farm in beautiful Dawsonville, Georgia. Over five... Boy, I'm glad Barry's not that scared Barry to death. Barry would cry. No, I guess Barry would weep.
Now I'm afraid to talk. Because... God, no. Oh, my gosh.
Pull yourself together.
Okay. Boy, that was kind of traumatic.
Yeah.
It happened. That kicked in just after I found my opera glasses.
You found your opera glasses?
Yes. I don't know if just the excitement. They've been missing 2 years, and I found them, and all of a sudden I'm Mr., you know, Captain America.
Yes, that's right.
Oh, my gosh. Well, I think I'm back to normal.
Well,
now.
It seems to have passed, yeah.
All right, let's move on. oh, my gosh. All right, I've got a couple of things to go over with.
Okay, let's do it.
Are you and Danny still going to be the greeters at the National Casserole Competition?
I don't think I've heard about that. Have we scheduled something that insane?
I sent you some invitations. Well, anyway, we need you there. because these people are going to be coming from all over the country.
Is this a paying gig?
A what?
A paying job?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay.
Yes, sir. All the casseroles you can eat, buddy.
Then we'll be there. What, are you entered, or are you kind of the past master of this thing?
No, I'm just kind of I'm the glue that's going to hold all this together.
Uh-huh.
You know.
Crazy glue, yeah.
Hold on a second.
Yeah.
My calls have come through. I've got some phones here, some friends help out. I'm trying to play a little prank on some different people.
Are you really?
Hello?
You ain't going to insist on it bobbing us?
Mr. Knight, is this Coach Bobby Knight of Indiana? Listen, I'm not going to try to explain who I am. You're what? You're seconds away from hanging up.
Mm-hmm.
Listen, I just want to tell you, Mr. Knight, I know you have that big bad temper and everything, but you know what Mike Ditka told me this morning? Said he could whip you. He said he'd tear you up. Okay. All right, bye-bye. Hold on a second. Here's another call. Hold on a second. I've got that one to connect this up. Hello? Mr. Ditka? Do you know what Bobby Knight just told me? Said he could whip you. Just stomp you all over the place, you foul-tempered man. You hate Christmas. You say if Jack Frost starts snipping at your nose, you're going to kill him. Boy, what a Scrooge. Okay, bye-bye. Hold on to that temper. I'll flap you. Bye. I hung up real quick. A little Christmas.
A little prank thing.
Yes, sir.
You have Prince Albert in a can, that sort of thing. Is your refrigerator running? You hear that music?
Does that mean I'm going?
That means bye-bye.
Evidently. we'll have to do this again.
Why? Why?
You're a silly man.
I'll talk to you.
See you later.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
1-800-572-8255. We'll be right back.
Spread a little loving. We'll keep moving on. Something always happens whenever we're together.
This is News Radio 960, the new WRFC, Athens, a Southern Broadcasting Company's radio station.
And talk to Joe, too. Hello, Joe.
Hello, Ludlow. Man, it's good to start off the top of the hour here. I want to get in on that national casserole competition.
I see you get all the details.
Yeah, okay. You got my mailing address. Have Rendezvous send me something on that, and I'm happy he found his opera glasses.
Yeah, makes you just feel better about the holidays, doesn't it?
Yeah, that makes my day to know that he still does a great job. By the way, I watched Ted Koppel a little bit last night on TV. How's Ted doing?
As far as I know, we hadn't heard from him in a while, but the last time I talked to him, he was doing very, very well.
Yeah, hadn't heard from Ted lately.
Been a while.
Well, I don't know what Denny put up on the computer. He and I chatted there a minute. I need some advice and counsel on something. I'm going back to college. Serious. Up here at the University of Maryland, they have a program for senior citizens. In fact, most states, for senior citizens over 60, you can go to college free. There's no tuition. Did you know that?
No, I didn't know that. That's nice.
Yeah, they've got it in South Carolina, and my sister encouraged me to check on it up here, and I have, and I'm in the process of applying. Classes start, I believe it's January the 27th. That's my Christmas present to me, Ludlow.
Well, good for you.
Yeah, it's...
You'll really enjoy that.
Yeah, I think so. I'm going to try to do a degree in 7 years. I'm really serious about this with my other work, my research and writing that I'm doing. I can't go full-time, you know.
Yeah.
And so I'll be reporting on that if that's all right.
Yeah, let us know how you're coming.
Okay, and... Anything else you need to know? Hey, this AirTran, do they fly in up here to Baltimore, Washington International Airport?
Yeah.
I'm going to check on them, okay?
All right, buddy, do tell them I told you to call.
Okay, we'll talk to you later.
All right, take care. 1-800-572-8255 is our number. You see how this works, gang? Wide open. And our friend in Baltimore, going back to college, I think that's neat. We got a couple of people taking advantage of some of those opportunities, and that's good. 1-800-572-8255. And quick reminder, I'm going to be tomorrow, 1 o'clock to 3 o'clock, in Ellijay, Georgia, at the Appalachian Bookstore. Get there a little bit before 1, be there till at least 3, and if you're up in that neck of the woods, come on by and say hello. What a beautiful area, and we're going to get to meet some new folks up there and renew some old acquaintances, so we're looking forward to that. And then Monday evening, 5 to 7, Spartanburg, South Carolina, at the Pick a Book Store. You're good.
I've had one, but I don't remember which company it was. They sent along a little, when they send the catalog, they send you a little, I know I've told you this, and forgive me for repeating it. They send you a little free tape, and it's nothing but commercials from those old shows.
Oh, yeah.
You know, just a line.
Yeah, and that's about as fun as old shows, isn't it?
It really is.
Yeah.
Sometimes I put it on and play it and just sit and think, oh, that went with, because a lot of the shows I don't remember.
Yeah.
I have a Christmas poem.
All right.
May I share it?
It's not too long, is it?
It's not terribly long.
Okay.
It's about 20 lines.
All right.
Short lines. I titled it The Chosen One. An angel came to Mary one day. In a spirit, she heard him say, "You are going to have a son. No ordinary child, but the anointed one. But, sir, I have not yet wed, nor have I lain in the marriage bed. Mary, this baby will be spirit conceived. Gently he her fears relieved. She yielded her will to the Father's desire. Within her began an inner fire, a fire of excitement and expectation, this young maid of humble station. The angel appeared to Joseph as well with the good news he had to tell. Joseph and Mary soon were wed, yet unknowing what lay ahead. There's a quiet and peaceful life, an ordinary carpenter and a young wife. As time for the birth grew near, so did the trip made each year. Mary on the donkey would ride as Joseph walked close beside. Travelers filled Bethlehem that night. No room, no room, none in sight. Wait, one innkeeper said, in the stall we'll make a bed. Mary stretched out with a thankful sigh. The birth surely must be nigh. A baby's cry soon filled the air, the son born to the chosen pair. The star shone so very bright as angels sang that holy night. Truly this was God's own son, come to earth, the chosen one.
Nice, nice, very nice. Merry Christmas to you, my friend.
Merry Christmas to you and to Miss Nancy.
We'll talk to you soon.
And to all the wackos.
Thank you.
Uh-huh,
bye. Bye-bye. 1-800-572-8255, Tucker, Georgia, and G on the radio. Hello, G.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm great, sir.
Beautiful morning.
It is absolutely breathtaking.
Yeah. Just an aside, we were in that little bookshop in Brunswick 2 weeks ago and looking through their books and stuff. Yeah, weren't you there signing?
Yeah, that's a great store.
Yeah, it is a nice store.
Yeah.
Yeah. I hear that somebody had taken exception to my saying, take a suitcase full of oatmeal to Scotland. Well, I just meant you can never have enough. And secondly, the Scottish grade may be a little coarser than ours. It's probably not like Quaker oats.
Well, we need to experiment.
Right.
Yeah.
You really do that. I think I'm retired now, and I'm going to go into more business farming for organic oatmeal.
All right.
I just had a couple of words I might suggest for Scotland. First of all, you don't want to glower at anybody. That's our version of a dirty look.
Yeah.
And secondly, don't banjo anybody unless you're sure he won't get up and come after you.
Oh, okay. local slang there.
Yeah, really bad when you banjo somebody. You beat them up pretty bad. And thirdly, if you pick up somebody by the oxters, you pick them up by the armpits. I don't know why they call him that.
I'm making notes. Well, it's always fun. That's part of the fun and the mystique of travel is picking up these local flavor and that sort of thing. Yeah. So we're looking forward to it.
When I was in the hospital a few years ago, my nurse was from Glasgow, and she was cleaning up my room, and she said, "Could I get you something else?" And I said, "How about a good single malt?" And she thought for a minute, and she said, "Is there a bad one?"
Gotta go, G. Take
all
care,
right.
Buddy. I'll talk to you soon.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Let's go to Pacolet, South Carolina, where Jack is patiently waiting. Good morning, Jack.
Good morning, Ludlow.
How you doing, pal?
I am doing fantastic.
Good.
It's the most beautiful day you would ever want to see.
I promise you it's a killer.
And I am tickled to death that you're going to be in Spartanburg.
Yeah, looking forward to it.
Well, I am... I've never met you or anything. I've been listening to you for a long, long time, and I've called in from time to time. And I am really, really, truly looking forward to meeting you.
Well, buddy, I'm looking forward to meeting you, too. That'll be fun.
And I will be in.
Good.
And see you, and have I got time for just a little bitty story?
Can you do it in about 30, 40 seconds?
Yeah. Well, this little granddaughter of mine started school this year. And the first day of school, I called her that afternoon. And I asked her, I said, "How did school go?" She said, "Grandpa, have you got a lot of time?" I said, "This is a long story."
Yeah, you're not going to believe what happened to me today, is what she said.
And she went on to say, "Now, if you get tired of listening to me, just tell me to shut up and hang up."
Oh, that's funny.
But I thought that was precious.
That is always fun. You take care of yourself, and I'll see you Monday afternoon.
All righty.
All right, bud. Take care.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. 1-800-572-8255. We'll be right back. I was looking at a TV commercial from a car dealer the other day, and they were tickled nearly about to death because they had 10 Jeep Wranglers in stock. They had 10 Wranglers in stock, and they bought a TV commercial to shout the news. Listen, gang, right this minute, Jasper Jeep has about 70 Wranglers sitting on their lot. Hard top, soft top, dual top. Pick a color, pick the equipment, and drive it home. They also have the beautiful new Dodge Durango and those great Dodge Ram pickups, all at those wonderful no-hassle, no-haggle Jasper Jeep, Dodge, Chrysler, Plymouth prices. Great time for you to see the beautiful Georgia Mountains and meet the nicest folks I know at Jasper Jeep, Dodge, Chrysler, Plymouth. Now then, open Monday through Saturday, 8 a.m. to 7 p.m., but never, ever on Sunday. Gang, no matter where you live, your car dealership is situated in beautiful Jasper, Georgia.
Hello?
I was going to do it, then I changed my mind about doing it. Now I'm doing it.
What?
Fenfen, to help me lose weight.
Fenfen's off the market, Cindy. It's been all over the news.
No!
Look, do what I'm doing. FenCal, a patented all-natural weight loss alternative.
Now I'm only 5 years old. I've got to do just what I'm told. Santa Claus is going to be dropping in on me. Is there something I might have missed? I had quite a few things on my list. I hope he can fit it all under that Christmas tree. Now I know what he likes for a late night snack. For years now it's been bringing him back milk and cookies. He'll come and go without a sound again.
All right, 1-800-572-8255 as we talk to Milton on the radio. Good morning, Milton.
Hello.
How are you?
Milton Crabapple.
Good morning, Sheriff.
I said it's Milton Crabapple.
I said good morning, Sheriff.
You know, you need to get that hearing checked, Ludlow.
I guess so.
OC just got him. By the way, how you doing, Ludlow?
I'm doing good, buddy.
I was going to tell you, because your bad hearing reminded me of it. OC just got him a new one of them kind of hearing aids that goes plumb away down in your ear and you can't even see it.
Yeah.
His wife, his whole family, and all of them went off visiting relatives, left OC at home for about a week, and he didn't have nothing to do, so he'd been thinking about getting him a hearing aid, so he just went and got one of them. I asked him how his family liked it. He said he ain't told them about it yet. Don't make no sense to me. I said, well, you ought to tell him. He said he could hear stuff going on all the way in the back of the house. He said he's done changed his will 3 times.
That's funny.
Well, I believe you ought to tell him myself.
Yeah, he needs to tell him. That's only fair.
You know, you was gone again this week. Was you making a speech?
No, I was signing books.
You was?
Yeah.
Did you get a bunch of them signed?
A bunch of them signed.
Selling a bunch of them, are you?
Yeah.
Well, that sounds good, Ludlow.
It's going very well.
I hope you sell a million of them.
Well, thank you.
Get sure of that radio job. I know that's a pain sometimes. Having to talk on the phone all day long, folks.
Yeah, you be some days better than others.
I'm leaving in the morning to go make a speech.
Oh, where are you going?
I'm going all the way up to Logansport, Indiana to make a speech.
All right, that's wonderful.
Say it's cold up there.
I expect so, yeah.
I was going on to take my fishing pole, but the fellas said they weren't much use. Said they weren't going to take me fishing.
Yeah.
They just wanted to hear me talk.
You'll love it.
Well, I hope so. I'm going up and coming back the next day.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I don't like to fly on them airplanes.
Yeah.
Sometimes you can't help it.
Mm-hmm.
You just can't get there quick enough. But anyhow, I just wanted to wish y'all and all the wackos, all the folks listening out there, happy holiday season.
Well, we thank you very, very much, and of course the same to you and your lovely wife.
And a Merry Christmas or Happy Benihana, whatever it is. I don't know. Whatever they celebrate, I hope they have a happy one.
Well, I hope so, too, and I'm glad you called, big boy.
Stop by the jail, Ludlow.
All right, enjoy your trip.
Much obliged.
Talk to you later.
Yes, sir.
Bye-bye. John Bleakley Winnebago, America's number one Winnebago dealer for 1997. Let's talk to the choo-choo man in Dallas. Hello, Chew.
Hello, Ludlow.
How are you on this bright, beautiful, clear day?
I'm just doing good, and
good.
It's good to hear the sheriff in there.
Yep.
Yeah, he sounds in good form today.
Fine pedal.
Yeah, buddy. I guess y'all are all getting ready for Christmas.
Doing our best.
You know, Luddy, it's only 6 more shopping days.
I know it.
And I remember last year when there was just 6 more shopping days. And it's just yesterday.
Yeah, I know it.
Boy, are they going by fast.
Yeah, they're too fast sometimes.
Yeah. Yeah, well, I reckon old Santa's, as we speak, making them toys. I wonder what he's got in mind for me this year.
Oh, I can't wait to find out.
I hope he don't mash his finger when he starts building mine. They just no telling.
I bet he's already got you a letter, and I bet it's already built. What you bet?
You reckon?
Yeah.
I hope so. It ain't no telling what it'll be, though.
No telling.
Well, I can't hardly wait. But I'll be kind of glad when it's over, Luddy.
Yeah, when you get the cleanup done and get the Christmas tree down and get it back to normal, whatever that is.
Yeah, what do you mean get it down? I ain't got it up yet.
Well, if you play your cards right, you can put it up one day and take it down the next.
Well, I think that's what Big Joe's got in mind.
Yeah, okay.
we got one of them little... Got a big artificial tree and one of them little and already decorated. See, all you got to do is get it out of the closet, take the plastic off it.
And pop it up.
Yeah.
That's probably the way to go.
Don't take long.
Probably the way to go. I need to get out of here, my man.
You have a big weekend.
All right, buddy, I'm going to do the same.
You be in here next week.
Oh, yeah.
Just... What, a couple of days and then...
Oh, you never know. I'll probably be here most of the week, yeah.
Uh-huh. Well, that won't be long.
All right, buddy. Listen,
it's Christmas.
I know.
All right, have a good one.
All right, take care.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. More conversation right after this.
Gotta sleep now, it's getting late. All night long I lie awake. Till Santa's gone, I just can't wait. I just can't wait. I just can't wait. Could be something I might have missed. I had quite a few things on my list. I hope he can fit it all under that Christmas tree. I hope he can fit it all under my Christmas tree.
we'll get that harmonica under there. We'll fit a guitar under there and a cowboy hat and bicycle maybe. Don't know what he's gonna do with that horse.
A classic city tradition for nearly 50 years. This is News Radio 960, the new WRFC, Athens.
Good morning, I'm Beth Larson with an information update on News Radio 960, the new WRFC. 56 degrees at 11:30, the official three-day forecast is coming up. A Hall County mother is expected back in court today. Barbara McBride could be extradited to Texas to face child custody charges. She and her 14-year-old daughter had been running from the girl's father since 1987. She claims her ex-husband sexually abused the girl. The teen is in a foster home until a custody hearing at the end of the month. Federal health officials have some advice for parents about toy safety. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention issued a report yesterday urging parents to use only age-appropriate toys, to supervise children directly, and to make sure that the toys are used properly. And there's no word of any survivors after today's crash of a Boeing 737 in Indonesia. The plane, owned by the Silk Air airline of Singapore, was carrying at least 104 people. Some reports say there were 106 on board. A search and rescue team is at the scene of the crash in a coastal area. Checking Wall Street, the Dow is down 189 points, NASDAQ down 30. News Radio 960 WRFC News Time, 11:31.
Think. Who would you like to call this very minute?
Your mom.
Your dad.
Your kid at college.
Your ex-wife.
Your mother-in-law.
Because you can make that call right now, absolutely free.
Yes, free. No strings attached, no hidden charges, no nothing.
All you have to do is dial 1-800-CALL-IDT. That's 800-CALL-IDT.
No, we're not crazy.
We're IDT's net-to-phone. Yes, net-to-phone, the incredible new way to make long-distance calls without a long-distance phone company.
That's right. Goodbye, AT&T. Adios, MCI. Sayonara, Sprint.
So dial 800-CALL-IDT right now.
Net-to-phone calls eliminate those huge long-distance charges because they're carried over the Internet.
But all you need is a telephone, and we never charge you more than 8 cents per minute.
Which is why Net-to-phone will be saving American consumers, and this means you, up to $1 billion a year.
But don't take our word for it. Experience it for yourself this very minute, free, by calling 1-800-CALL-IDT.
All you have to decide is who you want to call.
Net-to-phone, 800-CALL-IDT.
More with Ludlow Porches just ahead, but first, the official three-day forecast from WRFC meteorologist Kathy Francis.
Plenty of sunshine and nice today. Our high this afternoon, 66, mainly clear and chilly tonight, a low near 40. Tomorrow's sunny to partly cloudy, high 66. And on Sunday, mostly cloudy and colder, some rain possible. Sunday's high 50. Probability of rain on Sunday is 50%. This is meteorologist Kathy Francis with the official three-day forecast on News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
Currently clear skies and 56 degrees on South Millage Avenue in Athens. I'm Beth Larson, and you're up to date at 11:32. More news in less than 30 minutes and bulletins at once from News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire.
All right, let's go to Roswell, Georgia, and talk to the King of Roswell. Hello, Your Highness. How are you?
Fine, Ludlow. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you, bud.
Gentleman called about 30, 45 minutes ago about the Stoint Dooley.
Yeah.
I don't know if anyone's called in since, but you were exactly right. His name was George Ellis. Among the theaters that he owned in town was one at Ansley Mall.
Mm-hmm.
And I know after his death, I think it was then called the Ellis Cinema.
Yeah.
And he was quite a man, quite a gentleman.
No question about it. And gentle is the word. Just a great guy.
Yes, sir. On a personal note, as a young boy growing up here in Atlanta, on Friday nights at 11:30, I couldn't wait for Big Movie Shocker to come on. And at the end of the 11 o'clock news on Channel 5, Vice President and General Manager Dale Clark always had a short editorial.
Mm-hmm.
And it was an eternity for that man to stop talking so my scary movie could come on.
You had waited all that time.
Yes, sir.
You were ready.
I had the privilege of going to a Channel 5 Christmas party a few years ago, and I met him and relayed that story, and he and his wife just howled.
Oh, that's great.
Now, can we reminisce a little bit about old Atlanta?
Sure.
Okay. Long ago, of course, on Saturdays, the Atlanta newspapers had both a morning edition, the Constitution, and they also had a journal that was delivered in the afternoon.
Right.
In that journal, Ludlow, was a pull-out section which told you the TV listings for the coming week.
And it was green.
There you go. Well, my question was going to be, what did you call it?
The green sheet.
The green sheet is right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. That's all I had. You have a great holiday.
You take care. Call us often.
Yes, sir.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Let's go to Tryon, North Carolina, and Joe on the radio. Hello, Joe.
Hello, Ludlow. May I wish you and yours a very Merry Christmas and a very Happy New Year and the very best.
Thank you, thank you.
But Ludlow, I consider you a good businessman, which I know you are, and more or less a man with good common sense. I have always loved athletics. You know that.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Where are we going now in athletics? I thought athletics taught a young man how to win, how to lose, shake hands when you got your rear end whipped and this, that, and other, not get high-priced lawyers involved, not get governors of states involved, not get mayors of towns involved. But what is, where is the end? What is going to come?
Well, yeah, it's kind of just a microcosm of society in general. Those same problems exist all over society. I think they're more noticeable in particularly major league sports because of the tremendous amounts of money that are involved. I don't know how long before they cave in on themselves. I don't know.
I don't either, Ludlow, because you take Tennessee now. All right, but a fine young man, a fine young football player, but he was not selected to win the Heisman Trophy. Now the whole state is writing petitions, including the governor's leading that, to the New York Downtown Athletic Club.
Okay.
Then Latrell Sprewell, a basketball player, tries to choke a coach to death. All right, Johnny Cochran's involved in that. Then just Romanowski from the Denver Broncos, he spits in another black player's face, J.J. Stokes, and we're getting the racial issue involved, and we're getting everything involved in this thing. So where do we end?
Maybe we end it by not putting so much emphasis on it and not letting it become such a big part of our lives. Maybe. We think it's too important.
It is a life and death situation to some people, it seems, this day and time.
It really is. I was listening to a sports talk show the other day, and two guys on there and a caller, and they were all screaming at each other like it was life or death. I mean, screaming so you couldn't understand what anybody was saying, and it was about sports.
But it seems now what sports was originated for, to teach young men how to win and how to lose gracefully and this, that, and other, and lose like a man, but we have lost all perspective. As I say again, high-priced lawyers like Johnny Cochran and all that's involved in this, that, and the other. So.
Okay, got to go, buddy.
All right, thank you very much.
Take care of yourself. I'll talk to you soon. Let's go to Rome, Georgia, and talk to Ginger. Hi, Ginger.
Hey, Ludlow.
How you doing?
I'm doing great.
Good.
I am so excited. I was in the living room working a jigsaw puzzle because I love to work puzzles.
Mm-hmm.
I'm working on a 2,000-piece puzzle. And listening to your program, and I heard this man call saying he's a senior citizen, and he was going to go to college.
Right.
Just a few minutes ago.
Yeah.
And I said, by George, that's something I could do. So I went and called one of our local colleges, and they have the same program.
Wonder.
Where a senior citizen can go. And I am so excited because I can start college in May, and I love bookkeeping. And so I'm going to go for accounting.
Go.
And it's all because I was listening to you today.
Well,
and I heard that man, and I want to thank that man for calling in, because I would have gone the rest of my life never knowing this was available
to
me.
All right. Well, it is, and you're going, number one, you're going to have a lot of fun doing this.
Oh, and they're even going to let me work a little bit because this college has that. And I said, well, would my working go to help pay for my college, or would the money go to me? And she said, oh, no, the money would go to you.
All right.
And I thought, gosh, how great the life is.
I want you to keep us posted now as you move through your scholastic routine every day.
Well, I'll have to send you one of my graduation invitations.
I'll look forward to it.
Thanks, Ludlow.
Glad you called.
Okay, bye-bye.
1-800-572-8255. That's very, very nice. Out of the fog, into your heart, the inspector is here. Hello, Inspector.
Good morning, Monsieur Ludlow.
You started off the conversation with a sigh.
Yes.
Can you hold on 1 minute?
I can.
It may be a little long. I put you up too soon because I was so anxious to speak to your French self.
My French self is okay, sir.
Hang on, I'll get right back. Thank you, Denny, for that kind and gentle reminder. And duty. We'll be right back. High Pine Seekers, Ludlow Porch, my buddies at the Blue Willow Inn. Listen, when you get ready for that special meal, you think of the Blue Willow Inn. Superb southern food, beautiful surroundings, and service like you've always dreamed of having. Fried chicken, fried steak. If it's southern, they make it, and they make it better than anybody else. The Blue Willow Inn. You stop by and tell them Ludlow Porch sent you. Oh, you want to know where it is? It's in Social Circle, Georgia. Where else would it be?
John Blakely Winnebago in Douglasville, Georgia is America's number one Winnebago retailer for 1997. John Blakely has the largest selection of Winnebagos in the U.S. Choose from the all-new Chieftain, the redesigned Adventure, the Brave, Grand Tour, Luxor, Rialta, Mini, and Mini Winnie. The 1998 Brave SC from $39,995 or as little as $379 per month. John Blakely Winnebago in Douglasville, Georgia. Call toll-free 1-888-527-8287.
This is Art Bell.
A television cartoon based on the popular video game Pocket Monsters triggered convulsions in hundreds of children around Japan when a red, very bright red explosion flashed for 5 seconds on screens. 618 children suffered convulsions, vomiting, irritated eyes, and other symptoms.
Art Bell on News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
That is very interesting.
We often see a picture of Rodin's famous statue of a naked man sitting on a big rock in deep thought. What is he thinking? Possibly he's contemplating another type of rock that would enhance his thought process, or a faster chip. The Stone Store between Watkinsville and Athens on Highway 441. The Stone Store, the best thought processor rocks in the business.
The home of Ludlow Porch, News Radio 960, the new WRFC. All right, now we're going to go back to the inspector. Hello, Inspector.
Hey. Good morning, Michelle. Again.
Yes.
You wanted to speak it to me so bad that you missed your cue.
Yeah, exactly.
You silver tongue devil. Michelle, Denny sounded good on the jingle bells just then, Michelle.
Yes, he does. He's coming along.
Oh, that was either the change in his pocket, I don't know.
Or both.
Michelle, my Aunt Soufflé is here visiting me from the south of France.
Oh, really?
For the holidays.
Uh-huh.
And I did not know this, Monsieur, but she is, you are her heartthrob.
Really?
I think you say, yes. She said to me this morning, she was listening to you, and she said, she says, Jacques, she says, Denis, Kaye, before Zibnip. And I said, oh. And I guess the best way I could translate that, Monsieur, is she thinks you are a hot child in the city, Monsieur. Whatever that means.
It sounds flattering.
I would leave that to you.
It sounds,
your imagination. Oh, yes, yes. She loves you very much.
Sounds flattering.
She's even wanting to get a tattoo of your caricature on it.
You ought to settle for a refrigerator magazine. It's not as painful.
Oh, yes, yeah. That would be a good idea. I will tell her that.
Yeah.
But, Monsieur, have you ever had the dreamers that seemed like it was real and you woke up in a purple sweater?
Yes.
I don't know why I dreamed about the Fun Seekers Network last night. Again, maybe it was the mushrooms I ate just before going to bed or something.
Could but have been.
I dreamed that I was on the moon.
Uh-huh.
And of course, there is a lot of bleachers on the moon.
A lot of what?
A lot of bleachers. cheeses, like the blue cheese, to put on the blue cheese.
Oh, blue cheese.
Yes,
yeah.
Blue cheese.
Okay.
Yes, that's what I said.
Okay, and now I'm with you.
Okay, anyway, I miss you. There was the Buzzo Roberts clones and the cleaning lady clones, monsieur.
Oh, really?
Yes, and they were dressed in the pink and the white tights and tutus, fufus, doing the dance of the Christmas fairies.
Well, it was a nightmare, wasn't it?
Yeah, yeah. But the worst part about it was Buzzo Roberts and the cleaning lady, they were doing the pirouetting or whatever.
Yes.
And he grabbed her by the waist and threw her up in the air. But she never came back, monsieur. There's low gravity on the men, and I woke up. So I don't know if the cleaning lady is in orbit or somewhere else.
No, you woke up in a cold sweat.
Yes, a purple sweat, monsieur.
A purple sweat.
Yes.
All right.
I don't know. But anyway, I just, I told Nan Souffle I would call her, and I called to you and let you know that you have a heartthrob is out here from the south of France.
Well, you give her my warmest personal regards and my great wishes for a happy Christmas.
Okay, I will do that. And same to your families and to Monsieur Denier and everyone and all of your listeners out there. Merry Christmas from the inspectors and his family.
Take care of yourself.
Bonjour.
Talk to you.
Arrivederci.
Visit Colonel Pooh's Barbecue in East LJ, Georgia, and see the world-famous Pig Hill of Fame. Now we're going to go to one of the world's foremost educators, Professor Eric von Doppelganger. Hello, Professor.
And good morning to you, kind sir.
How are you?
I am better.
Good.
Better than you and better than most.
Yep, I'm sure.
I had the inspector mention the cleaning lady. A cleaning lady is a scholar and a lady, no doubt about it.
No question.
I was listening to her the other day talking about Sand Hill Cranes.
Yeah.
Woody Duck.
Yeah.
And she'd been seeing flocks of one and two.
Little bitty flocks, would you?
I've been wanting to see that.
Mm.
But anyway.
Yeah.
I've been up trying to memorize the Library of Congress.
And succeeding, I would imagine.
Yeah, next week I'm going to try a full sentence. one other thing before I get into my trivia.
All right.
The gentleman talking about sports.
Yeah.
Says sports was originated to teach men, you know, various things about citizenship and so forth.
Yeah.
Sports originated to teach men to hunt and fight.
Okay. Same thing.
Yeah.
Now, do you have some of the impossible trivia for us today?
Yeah, I tried to find some that would appeal to you out of movies and TV.
All right.
Who played Senator Ruth Martin in The Silence of the Lambs?
I don't even remember the character. It'd just be a guess.
Diane Baker.
Okay. Now I remember the scene. Okay.
Okay. Two actresses who played Lois Lane in the 50s TV Superman series.
Oh, Noel Neal and somebody named Phyllis Coates.
It wouldn't, but somebody named Phyllis Coates. It was Phyllis Coates.
Well, okay. Are you picky today? First you attack the poor cleaning woman.
you know, I ain't got it in a while. I got to get all my digs in. all right. Move it along.
Moving right along, as they say.
Yeah. And, of course, you consider baseball a fair game. Who holds the record, major league record, for the most games lost in a lifetime?
Are you talking about a pitcher?
Mm-hmm.
A Cy Young.
That's absolutely right. Man, you're ahead of me this morning. You got up early.
I sure did. Which had nothing to do with my alertness.
He also holds the record for the most games won.
Yeah.
He also holds the record for the most innings pitched. He holds the record for the most complete game.
Yeah, most miles going to the baseball park, yeah.
All right. What do these five women have in common? And you'll get it by the time I get to the end of them, so just feel free to break in any time.
Okay.
Mary Jeanette Kelly. Mary Ann Nichols. Annie Chapman. Catherine Edders.
Victims of the Jack the Ripper.
It's absolutely correct. Hey, you're on top of it this morning.
I almost couldn't remember Jack the Ripper's title.
There has recently been a book published that claims that they found a diary by a man named Maybrick that owned up to being Jack the Ripper and gave some many details that he almost had to be.
Yeah, I haven't found a book, but I'm gonna try to read that before I go to London. But I'm gonna try to take that Jack the Ripper tour over there.
You want to borrow my copy?
No, just hang on to it, cause I'd rather own it. But thank you.
Well, I
pretty much wore you out today.
Yeah, you did.
Yeah.
That put you about 5,000 questions behind me.
Well, you couldn't resist that, could you?
No.
Couldn't resist that one bit. I got to get out of here, cousin.
Obviously.
You take care of yourself. Talk to you soon.
All right.
Bye-bye. 1-800-572-8255. We'll be right back. Sad or happy, the fact of the matter is that sooner or later, you're going to need to buy some carpet. If you're a woman, you're going to do it because you know it's the natural order of things. If you're a man, you're going to do it because your wife makes you. No matter the reason, I want you dealing with my friends at Myers Carpet Company, Dalton, Georgia, and Atlanta. Yes, sir, Myers Carpet Company, the oldest Mill Direct carpet outlet in Dalton, Georgia, the carpet capital of the world. Now, I don't want you to fool around when you buy carpet. Because if you're not careful, and I mean real careful, you can spend way too much money on your carpet. Myers Carpet, you remember that name. Two great locations, Atlanta and Dalton. Here's what you do for free samples and a price list. 1-800-297-1972. That's 1-800-297-1972. Myers Carpet, tell them Ludlow told you to call.
News Radio 960, the new WRFC, gives you the latest information every 30 minutes with updates from Athens' largest broadcast news team. Extensive coverage of events that affect you most. In Athens, Northeast Georgia, the nation and the world.
Here's reporter Mark Aylwine of ABC affiliate WRFC, Athens, Georgia.
Police are continuing their investigation and
your
charges
for reliable, frequent, informative news, weather, and sports. News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
Because you'll find the perfect gift for any occasion.
Merry Christmas, darling.
Oh, I love it.
Thousands of CDs.
Happy birthday, sweetheart.
Oh, thanks, honey.
Books from science fiction to nonfiction.
Happy Father's Day, dear.
This is so cool.
Videos and movies.
Happy anniversary, honey.
Oops. And a huge selection of calendars. Discover thousands of gift ideas at Borders. Books, music, video, and a cafe. Come inside.
Hello.
Hi, Jane. What'd you do today?
Well, I jogged 5 miles, went to work, hosted a dinner party, and read a bestseller.
All that and read a bestseller?
Sure, because the book was an audiobook. Today's bestsellers read on cassette, so I listened while I was exercising, driving, and cooking.
Great idea.
Expensive? Not the way I get them. I call the Columbia House Audiobook Club. You know, you should call, too, and learn how to get any 4 audiobooks for 99 cents.
And so should you. Just call 1-800-456-8352. To learn how you can get any 4 audiobooks for just 99 cents. Listen while you drive, exercise, anytime, any place.
Now I enjoy a new bestseller every week.
I'm calling right now.
Call 1-800-456-8352 for any 4 books on cassette for 99 cents when you buy one at full price. Does not include shipping and handling. Members must purchase 3 more titles over the next 2 years at regular club prices. Satisfaction guaranteed. Call 1-800-456-8352.
No heavy topics here, gang, just fun conversation. I'm Ludlow Porch. Join me weekdays, 10 to noon on News Radio 960, the new WRFC.
I'm going to sing a French Christmas carol.
considerable antiquity. It's called Bring a Torch. A torch is an element that goes back, we think, to the old Jewish festival of lights, or probably called Hanukkah. And that, as you may know, predates Christmas by several hundred years. Bring a torch, Jeanette, Isabella.
You know who that is?
Bring a torch to the cradle.
Archie Bunker. Darien, Georgia, and Bill. Hello, Bill.
Good morning, little old. How you doing this beautiful day?
I'm fine, sir, and I hope you are.
Oh, yes, sir, and it's about 60 degrees here, and the sun's shining pretty and bright. It's just a wonderful day.
Well, good for you.
I just want to wish everybody, you and your staff, and everybody out there, a Merry Christmas, and I think it'd be a good time of the year that we all say a little prayer somewhere down the line for each other, and it's just so good to have your programs you can sit down and listen to, and no interference much, and it's just wonderful.
Well, and it's great to have you be able to hear it and to call us. Well, that's wonderful.
And I tell you, it's just about time you think you get into Christmas spirit. Now, there was a boy that went to school with my children. He got killed up the road here about 4 miles this morning, I understand.
Oh, that's awful.
And, you know, it's just, I just hope everybody will try to have a safe Christmas.
Yeah, they it's, you know, it's bad to lose a young fellow like that any time, but to lose him right here at Christmas is so much tougher on his family and everybody.
It certainly is, and I know there ain't nobody been mentioning about eating turkey for Christmas, but I tell you, my wife and I, we always get one about 20 pounds. We have a pretty good-sized family, and take it to a barbecue place and get it barbecued and chipped up and, mm-hmm. and put the mild sauce on it, because you can always add. And then get about a half a gallon of barbecue hash and get that stuff all good and hot and put that hash on that box. Oh, man, that's some good eating.
To wipe you out for the holidays.
It is. A lot of people just don't know it, but and a lot of people probably wouldn't like it, but I really do love it.
Yeah, I do, too. I'm glad you called, my friend.
Thank you, sir. You have a Merry Christmas if I don't get to talk to you anymore.
Okay, take care of yourself.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. 1-800-572-8255. We're going to have to get out of here in a minute or two, but I would like to remind everybody in Ellijay, Blue Ridge, all up in my mountains, that I'm going to be at the Appalachian Bookstore there in Ellijay tomorrow, 1 o'clock, 1 to 3, and I sure would like for you to come by and just say hello. I'll be signing books, but if you don't need any books, just come by and say hello anyway. So we'll be right there. Then another one of my special places, Spartanburg, Monday afternoon, 5 to 7, I'll be there signing You're Sitting on Boomy at the Pick a Book. So I hope one of those two places you can get out this this weekend and visit with us a little bit, and maybe we'll help you wind up some of your shopping. It's been fun today, and I want you to stick around now, because your local news is coming up, and the best place for you to be well informed is right where you are on your local radio station. Between 9 and Monday, you do me a favor. Whatever else you do today, you find somebody to be nice to.
Of ABC, CNN, CBS, and AP. This is News Radio 960, the new WRFC Athens.
Good afternoon. I'm Mark Alewine, and you're listening to the Athens Noon Update on News Radio 960, the new WRFC. We have sunshine. It's 58 degrees on South Millage Avenue.
This is WRFC meteorologist Kathy Francis. The official three-day forecast is coming up on the Athens Noon Update.
Some of the stories we're following for you this noon. Jurors have started their fourth day of deliberations in the Oklahoma City bombing trial of Terry Nichols. We'll have reaction for you to Mike Bobo's arrest Wednesday night in Normaltown, and a Wilkes County man dies in an Oglethorpe County quarry accident.
I'm David Johnston with sports, where the Georgia Lady Bulldogs got back in the win column as they knocked off Central Michigan. The Georgia men play tomorrow, and the Hawks have a big game tonight against the Lakers in the Georgia Dome.
So far, Wall Street has not been a very fun ride today. At noon, the Dow Jones 30 Industrials down more than 188 points. The NASDAQ is down 30 points, and the S&P 500 down 21 points. We'll follow those stories and much more coming up for you this hour on the Athens Noon Update from News Radio 960, the new WRFC. It's 12 noon.
From ABC News, I'm John Belmont. Looking fear in the face on Wall Street today.
Short-term markets move on fear and greed, and fear has got a firm hold of today's market.
Michael Farr on the downhill ride at Farr, Miller & Washington in Washington. The Dow Jones Industrial Average has plunged almost 270 points so far today, but it's rebounded 100 to now it's off 170. Foreign markets had another rough night. Tokyo stocks giving up an additional 5%, but most American investors are still looking at a green Christmas. The Dow ahead 18% on the year. We'll keep watching the market throughout the day. Going to be a short day for the Terry Nichols jury. That is, unless they reach a verdict by early afternoon. ABC's John Bascom is live outside the federal courthouse in Denver.
John, the Terry Nichols jury might be called the weary dozen. They look tired at the end of their third day of deliberation. The judge telling them, we know you've been given a lot of evidence. It's been a long trial. They've been at it now for almost as long as the McVeigh jury. But as the judge noted, there's more evidence in this case. A lot of it's circumstantial, which means it probably sparks more debate behind closed doors. And as we speak, John, attorneys for both sides are headed back into the courthouse. A sign the jury may either have a question or may have wrapped it up. John?
John Bascom, live in Denver. With two deadly shootings since yesterday by disgruntled workers in Milwaukee and Orange County, California, you got to wonder what's wrong.